Welcome to chapter 5 that will discuss the social system of animals, or in other words, sex and politics. To reproduce, female and male gametes must meet. In the first video, we'll see that this does not always require the females and males to meet up in person. Organisms that are sessile, as well as many non-sessile ones, release their gametes into the environment with the hope that they will find each other. This is called external fertilization, which is rather common in marine animals from corals to fish. In the last chapter, we will encounter it again in plants. In terrestrial animals, fertilization is almost always internal and requires females and males to interact physically. In most animals, this interaction is limited to mating. But in many higher animals, their affairs last much longer, for one or more breeding season or even until death us part.
The second video will be about birds that are largely monogamous, one male and one female that raise together their offspring. We will also describe other social systems found in birds. In the big mammals, describing the third video, we find, in addition to monogamy, more complex social systems. From now on, the themes of territory and social hierarchy will appear time and again. In a harem, one male dominates multiple females with whom he mates and whom he fanatically protects. King Solomon and the Ottoman Sultan has harems, but they have not invented them. We will visit harems in hippos, elephant seals, zebras, and elks. This social organization selects for big and strong males, often leading to marked sexual dimorphism.
Cognitive skills and social organization, first and foremost for reproduction, evolved hand in hand. Sex thus did not only trigger the evolution of beauty, but also that of cognition and communication skills. This takes us to the fourth video that deals with monkeys and apes, who mostly live in highly complex and dynamic troops. Intelligence and the capacity to communicate are essential for maintaining these communities and for individuals to thrive in them. In the fifth video, we will meet cooperative breeding, where the entire group cares for the offspring of a breeding pair. We will meet Arabian babblers, painted dogs, and social insects to try and understand this social system.
Elephants are, side by side with apes and marine mammals, the most highly evolved cognitive and communicative creatures. It is fascinating that these capacities evolved in this group completely independently. In the sixth video, we will talk about the life of elephants and describe the social system based on herds led by senior females. In the last video, I will interview the psychiatrist Professor Yoram Yuval, who specialized in human relationships and wrote the bestseller about love. I will ask him questions proposed by the students of this course.